realization that the Peregrine was in trouble didn't come until the early 1960s, but we can track backwards from that, and we can note that the Peregrine Falcon was disappearing from some areas within its range, particularly in North America.
DDT, an extensively used pesticide, turned out to cause eggshell thinning in birds, so that while it appeared adults were reproducing normally and doing the kinds of things adults do, they weren't producing young.
And we started seeing this problem in the 40s and 50s. And basically, by 1962 or so, we lost our last peregrine falcon east of the Mississippi River.
And it was only at a conference that was called in Madison, Wisconsin, that all the scientists of the world came together and talked about the peregrine falcon and realized that, in fact, DDT was the likely culprit. It took another 6 years till 1972 before DDT was banned by the newly formed Environmental Protection Agency. But by that time, of course, the peregrine was gone. And the question became, well, what can we do about this? And that was when the group at Cornell University under Dr. Tom Cade thought, well, maybe we can find some way to engage in restoration work.
We established the Peregrine Fund in 1970 to attempt to learn how to propagate peregrine falcons in captivity.
Cornell University, Tom Cade, Bill Burnham, and others started producing peregrine falcons, and it was not an easy job. If you had to start this all over tomorrow and had no captive-raised peregrines, I mean, the notion of trapping or taking wild peregrines, putting them in an artificial structure and hoping they breed, the first peregrines would have been very difficult to produce. And they had to really start from some tough beginnings to produce a nucleus of captive-producing peregrines.
Peregrines were successfully bred in captivity in the early 1970s.
They started breeding large falcons. They figured out how to build these structures called hack towers, how to provide food for these young, inexperienced, naive young 40-day-old peregrines, try to release them in areas where there were minimal number of predators or danger. And so the Peregrine Fund really started this ball rolling for us in the United States and North America.